It's a little video about a futon that the kids bent the backrest and pinched the round tube. Being poor, you gotta fix things, so I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna fix this. And I'm gonna go to the garage for that. You can see here how badly twisted the metal is. You tore it up pretty good. And what I did was I had an old steering shaft from an old car. Basically you need something tapered where you could get down into the pipe and then beat it down in there. First I reformed the end of the pipe with a piece of, I think this is 3/4 inch pipe with an elbow on it. It's a gas pipe. I was able to beat that down in there and then to the bolt hole there, and then use the steering shaft to open up where the other side of the tube on the other side of the crack was all flattened out, and then I beat this all the way down to where now it's round again. I'm going to do the same thing over here, and then got a longer section of this pipe I'm gonna cut so that the pipe is in here all the way to here to make it stronger, and then I'll drill through the pipe and then I'll remount it onto the bed and it'll be nice and strong. And I don't think I'll have any welding involved because this is all still holding on, and this real thin Chinese metal, you don't want to try and weld, it just disappears when you hit it with heat. Okay, be back in a second. Okay, I'm lucky I used to be a mechanic, so I got lots of hand tools. Got an old vise on the bench, and I took and sawed these pipes, gas pipe off at 20 inches a piece. And then we're gonna go over here, see how it fits. See that? Fit right in there. And this mounts flush, so it has to be able to fit down to where this nipple, you don't want it any longer than where this gets small, because you're not going to get it in there. Now I've got to go straighten out the other side. I'm going to drill some holes in here and then try and make sure the bolts fit, and then I'll put it back on and hopefully the kids can't break it anymore because it'll be super strong inside there. I'll be back. Alright, here's one more thing I want to mention. Where these holes go through, they're stamped and it leaves this little round disc of metal gets pushed inside these holes. So as I drove the pipe through, it knocked some of them off and some of them plugged the hole. So I had to take some wire cutters and kind of get in there and wiggle them out and snap them off. And then I beat the pipe down into there and then tap the sides to reshape the pipe. Now we could pull that back out and put in our new support. Flush. And while I was working on that one, the other one fell in. If you could see that, so I'm going to have to just stand it up, tap on it till it falls back where it's flush. Then I'll drill the holes. Okay, moved outside into the weather. You can see where the pipe is in here. You're going to need a center punch to make life easy. It's not required, but if you punch a little dent right there for your drill bit to start, it's going to make life a lot easier when you drill it. And I've got cheap Harbor Freight drill that I keep around. Batteries don't last for much, but it works. And it's called a step bit. I'm going to go in as far as I need to get the hole the right size of the screw. And I'll probably have to, because this is a step bit, drill from this side and then turn it over and drill from the other side. Or I might go straight through with a different bit. We have to see how it works. Alright, I'm going to do the drilling. And I'll be back. Okay, so we all know drilling is no fun. So, this was, step bit was taking forever to get through the surface of this pipe. So I went and got a smaller bit, drilled it all the way through, and then opened the hole up on each side with the step bit. You're going to need a good small bit to get that started, because the step bit will start, but it takes forever. Okay, I ran into a slight alignment issue. And there you go. So I got the one bolt to go through real good. Okay, and that kept this other one from moving around. And then once you get that one locked in, you can go ahead and open these holes up. You want to go a size or two bigger than your bolt, so you got some room to play with in case it don't line up perfect. When you tighten it down, it'll be fine anyway. All right, well, there it is. Bolts are in there holding the pipe to the metal. It's all welded together, so should be fine. And just when you think you might have your job done, you should have tapped this thing on the concrete. You don't want that pile of metal shavings in your house getting in your feet. Then go back and clean up your metal shavings. Oh, I was going to go in and put it back together, and then I noticed the fat teenage daughters have busted off the mattress holders. So now I've got to try and weld this cheap China thin metal with a big gaping hole. We'll see how that goes. Well, there you go. There's a couple of cheap amateurish welds, but it's strong again. That metal on the lowest setting was trying to just disappear because there's just no iron in this Chinese steel. Beef this one up, fix that one. These hold the cushion onto the bed so it don't slip off, because it's like a big mattress when you lay it out. So, okay. I guess we'll let that cool off, throw some paint at it, and then we can start putting back together. Alright, threw a little paint at it. We're going to leave it sit out here in the sun for a while to cure the paint. And then we'll put it back together. One thing though, when you're flipping these things around, it's not only got cheap Chinese metal, it's got cheap Chinese paint. And I had to do all kinds of touch-ups. Over here where I was, you can see where I flattened the tube and everything. When I was straightening it, I was destroying this top rail. This is hidden behind the couch, so it's not a real big deal, but you might want to try and put some cardboard down so you don't scratch the heck out of it. I had to waste a whole can of spray paint on this thing. Well, there it is. All bolted back together. I guess the moral of this story is, if you have two unruly teenage overweight daughters, make them sit on the floor. So you ain't got to do all kinds of welding and all kinds of other things, you know. Raising kids is a challenge. Make your life interesting. Well, I hope this helped you if you broke your futon, or if you lack any, you know, kind of wondering if you should fix something that really ain't worth it. Well, this was worth it, because it's just a nice piece of furniture when it's all put together. Besides, the dog loves it. It's her favorite spot. It'll get her off my bed. All right, so everybody have a good day. Wish you luck. Bye.